Good morning, everyone. Welcome back. Today, we're doing a yoga class to reconnect and ground. Reconnect deep inside. Ground into the earth. And for that, let's start with closing our eyes. Be in a comfortable seated position and feel how your sitting bones are rooting into the ground. Take a deep inhale, rise a little bit taller from the crown of your head. Exhale. Deep inhale again, rise a little taller. Exhale. With your third inhale, bring your arms overhead, bring your palms together. Exhale, lower your hands in between your eyebrows and then to your heart. This frequency is good to connect you to your body, the Om. It's the beginning of the end of the universe and it vibrates really nicely inside of you. With your next inhale, bring your arms back up again. Exhale, bring your right fingertips down to the floor and reach your left fingertips up tall. You can walk those fingertips out to the side. So you come into a side stretch. Make sure that both of your sitting bones stay rooted well into the ground. By the way, if it's really uncomfortable for you to sit cross-legged like this, because your knees don't come far down, then you can sit on a folded blanket. If it's not good for your knees to sit like this, then you can choose a different seat. But most likely, some cushioning under your bottom will do, or some elevation to be precise. If you want to go a little deeper, reach those fingertips up taller and look past that right, that left arm. Last inhale here, reach tall. Exhale, come back to center. Inhale, walk your left fingertips out as far as they go. And reach that right arm up. And take some deep breaths here and find a lot of length in your side body. If your neck is okay with it, look past your arm. And open up that heart a little more towards the sky. Two more breaths here. Reach your fingertips a little taller. Exhale, come back to center. Good. And then take your left fingertips onto your right knee and come into a gentle first twist. Take your right hand close behind you and then look over that shoulder. With every inhale, grow a little taller. And with every exhale, root a little deeper and go a little deeper into your twist. There is no forcing, there is always just gentle encouragement and exploration. When you hit your edge, you stay right there and just keep breathing. Take two more deep breaths here. Last inhale. Exhale, come back to center. Inhale, twist towards the other side. Arm goes close behind your spine. The other hand grabs the knee. Sit up nice and tall, and with every exhale, twist a tiny bit deeper. may not be visible from the outside, but you can feel it from the inside if you continue with some micro movements. And then see if you can let go of all those thoughts passing through. They don't matter right now. If they matter, they'll still be there by the end of your practice. For now, just stay focused on your breath. Two more breaths here. Last inhale here. Exhale, come back to center. And then come forward onto your hands and your knees into a tabletop position. Inhale, let your belly sink down, reach your heart forward a lot. Exhale, round your spine. Inhale, reach your heart forward, let your belly sink down, lift your gaze. Exhale, round your spine, tuck your chin, tuck your tailbone. Inhale, reach your heart forward, shoulders draw back. Exhale, round it out. Two more. Inhale, reach your heart forward. If you like, come onto your fingertips for this one to strengthen your hands and wrists. Exhale, round. Inhale, reach your heart forward. Exhale, round. Your next inhale, come back to a neutral back position. And then bring your right leg up towards the back, press it back. With the exhale, bring the knee to your forehead as far as you can, bring them together. Inhale, reach that heel as far away as you can. Exhale, knee to forehead. Inhale, press back the heel, lengthen, exhale, knee to forehead. Inhale, press the heel back, exhale, this time we're going to pull the knee forward but then step it in between those hands. And we'll come into a low lunge. So make sure that your hips are in front of that back knee so you feel a stretch in your left hip flexor. And then be up on your fingertips here and reach your heart forward really tall. And your front ankle is right underneath your knee for stability. With your next inhale, bring your arms up. Make sure to keep your lower belly firm to protect your lower back. Reach with every inhale. Open your heart space a little wider. Exhale, open your elbows into cactus arms. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus arms. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus arms. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bring your hands back down. Inhale, tuck the back toes, lift the knee off the mat. Exhale, step it forward into a forward fold. Hang out here for a moment. Find your way into the pose. Your knees can be bent quite a bit if this is tough on your lower back. Your knees can be wider if you have really tight hamstrings. Your hands can be on your shins for support. Or you can just let your head dangle if this is okay for you. It doesn't matter whether your hands can touch the floor or not. With every inhale, activate those legs, press into your heels, and reach your sitting bones up towards the sky. And with every exhale, relax your upper body. Inhale, reach those sitting bones up. Exhale, relax the upper body. Maybe you gently shake your head yes and no here. And then with your next inhale, slowly roll up to standing. come into mountain pose. Open your hands towards the front. Let your shoulder blades glide down your back. Reach your heart up. Let your tailbone sink down. Let the crown of your head, the top of your head, reach up towards the sky. And feel how strong you're rooted in the earth with your feet. Lift your toes, spread your toes, place them back down. Inhale your arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come halfway up, hands on your shins, heart reaches forward. Exhale, fold back down. This time step the right leg back, very far back, and we'll come into a low lunge on the other side. Untuck your back toes. And then make sure you have your knee ankle alignment and your right knee is far back so you get a nice stretch here. Come up onto your fingertips, reach your heart forward and find a little more length with every inhale. With your next inhale, bring your arms up. Keep your lower belly firm here. With every inhale, reach your fingertips up taller. Open your heart a little wider. And with your exhale, open into cactus arms. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus arms. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus arms. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus arms, last time. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bring your hands back down. Inhale, tuck your back toes, lift the knee off the mat. Exhale, step your left leg back, plank pose. Inhale here. Exhale, lower knees, chest and chin. Inhale, scoot your heart forward, come into a baby cobra. Elbows pulled back, shoulders pulled back. Heart reaches forward. Tippy toes pull back. One more inhale here. Exhale. Inhale, press into tabletop hands and knees and then tuck your toes. Exhale, lift your hips into downward facing dog. So your hips are your highest point. Your fingers are spread really wide. Press all your knuckles into the mat. Heels reach towards the mat. Doesn't matter if they don't reach. And then find some length in your spine here and pull your shoulder blades away from each other. Breathe deep. One more breath here. With your next inhale, lift your right leg off the mat. Exhale, pull the knee into your chest and step it through at the bottom of your exhale. Inhale, reach your arms up, come up into a high lunge. Exhale, stay here. Inhale, root through that right heel and the left toes. And feel your strong base here. Lower belly is engaged. Your exhale, bring your hands to your heart and we'll come into a twist. So take your left elbow and tuck it outside the right thigh. And if it's okay for your neck, then look over your right shoulder. Your right knee continues to pull to the front. Your left heel pulls towards the back. By keeping your legs super active, you maintain stability here. Take one more deep breath here. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale. Let your hands frame your foot. Hop a little closer and then straighten your front leg as far as available to you. You can take blocks here or you can put your hands on your shins if this is too much of a reach. With every inhale, reach your heart forward a little more. And with every exhale, soften. Continue to maintain really active legs by pressing your right foot and your left foot firmly into the ground and away from each other. One more breath here. With your exhale, step it forward. Inhale, come halfway up, hands on your shins. Exhale, fold back down. Inhale, come all the way up to standing, arms reach high. Exhale, lower your hands to your heart. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come halfway up, high dragonfly. Exhale, fold forward. Frame your left foot, step the right foot back. Come into a high lunge, reach your arms up. Hold here. Root firmly through that left foot and the right balls of your foot. Keep your lower belly really active. One more inhale here, reach your heart up. Exhale, lower your hands to your heart. And then take your right elbow outside the left thigh and come into a twist here. You're aiming with your hands at the center of your heart. Don't worry if you don't get there all the way. Neither am I. Well, that's where we're trying to get to, eventually. And if your neck is okay with it, look over your left shoulder. Keep reaching through that left knee and that right heel. Keep your legs really active. One more deep inhale here. Exhale, come back to center. Frame your front foot. Hop a little bit closer. And then start straightening that front leg as far as available to you today. With your inhale, reach your heart forward. With your exhale, gently soften your upper body. Inhale, find a strong grounding in your feet. Exhale, relax the upper body, especially your neck. Last inhale here. And then press your hands into the ground, bend the front knee and step it back into downward facing dog. Stay here for two breaths. Now we'll do that same sequence, but not hold the poses as long. So we're going to inhale the right leg up, exhale, pull the knee into your chest, step it forward, inhale your arms up, high lunge. Exhale, hands to heart, come into a twist. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, straighten out over your front leg. Inhale, step it forward, forward fold, exhale here. Inhale, come halfway up, hands on your shins, exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come all the way up to standing, arms reach tall. Exhale, lower your hands to your heart. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come halfway up. Exhale, place your hands back down, right leg steps back. High lunge. Inhale, your arms up here. Exhale, lower your hands to your heart. Bring your right elbow on the outside of the thigh. Inhale here. Exhale, come back to center. Shorten your stance. Lower over that left leg. Inhale here. Exhale, step it back into downward facing dog. Good, two breaths here. With your next inhale, we'll do the same thing again, once more. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, step it forward, high lunge. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to heart. Stick it on the outside of that right thigh. Inhale here. Exhale, come back to center. Inhale, straighten front leg. Exhale, lengthen here. Inhale, step forward into forward fold. Exhale here. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, all the way up to standing. Add a slight back bend if you wish. From the heart, not from your lower back. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, arms up. Another option for slight back bend. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come halfway up, hands on your shins. Exhale, step the right leg back, high lunge. Inhale, your arms up. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, into your twist. Exhale, straighten out over that front leg. Inhale here. Exhale, hands on the ground and step your left leg back into downward facing dog. Two breaths here. Well done. Two down, one to go. The dragonfly is back. With your next inhale, lift the right leg. Exhale, pull the knee into your chest and step it through. High lunge. Inhale, your arms up. Exhale, hands to heart. Left elbow goes on the outside of the right thigh. Inhale into your twist. Exhale, come back to center. Straighten out your front leg. Inhale, step it forward. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, come up halfway. Exhale, back down. Inhale, come all the way up to standing. Arms reach high, option for back bend. Exhale, lower your hands to your heart. Inhale, arms up. Back bend if you wish. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway up, hands on shins. Exhale, hands down, step the right leg back. High lunge. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to heart. Tuck the right elbow on the outside of the left thigh. Inhale, into your twist. Exhale, straighten out over your front leg. Inhale here. Exhale, step it back into downward facing dog. Inhale here. With your next inhale, firm those hands and then see if you can bring both of your elbows down at the same time onto the mat. Good. That doesn't quite work yet. Do one at a time and just keep practicing that. So we're in dolphin pose here, and we're going to reach our heart towards our thighs. Neck is relaxed, and this is very strengthening for your shoulders. Make sure your shoulders are far away from your ears. your next inhale, bring your knees down, keep your toes tucked, and slowly roll up until you're sitting on your heels here. Hold that toe stretch for a few breaths. It can get quite intense. If it's too much, you can lean forward to take some of your weight out. And just feel how strongly you're grounded into the earth and how you can grow out of that base. With your next inhale, we're going to come back down onto our forearms. We'll go back into dolphin pose. And then we can play a little bit with preparation for headstand. Only do this if your neck is healthy and if you feel comfortable with this. You don't have to put any weight on the neck. Actually, you can leave all your weight on your forearms and just play with your weight around there. So, forearms back on the floor. This time we're going to interlace fingers. And then you reach your hips up tall. And maybe this is exactly where you stay. This is one variation of dolphin pose. This is great for shoulder strengthening. You're working a lot. If you wish, you can add a little more by shifting your weight forward until your nose is over your thumbs and then pressing back again. This is great to develop more strength in your shoulders. If you do wish to play with balance a little, then you can place your head in between those interlaced hands and walk your feet closer. And then maybe you come onto your tippy toes. Maybe you lift one leg off at a time. And this is a great place to stay. All these places are great to stay. And you'll notice that once your weight is stacked over your shoulders, once your hips are over your shoulders, you can lift. And you may get there today, you may not, and either way is okay. And then you can straighten your legs. So keep playing with that, whether you're in your dolphin, whether you have a couple of tippy toes lifting off or not, or whether you're in a full inversion. You're doing well, just keep breathing deep. Take two more breaths wherever you are. And then exhale and slowly make your way back down onto the earth, or if you're still on the earth, bring your knees back down, come back into a child's pose, rest your arms by your side, and relax here. For a little counter pose, we're going to grab our heels and bring our forehead closer to our knees and then roll up onto the head as far as is available to you. My arms are pretty short, so I'm not rolling very far, and that's okay. But you can feel the rounding in the back and how it creates a counter stretch. Last inhale here. Exhale, slowly roll up to seated from here. Beautiful work. And then we're going to come into a twisted seat. So sit to the left of your sitting bones and then take that right leg around. If this doesn't quite work, you can always straighten out that bottom leg. And then with your inhale, come really close to that right knee. wrap your left arm around the right knee or go past that knee, depending on how available this pose is to you. Bring your right arm close behind you and then go deeper into your twist. With every inhale, you sit up a little taller, and with every exhale, you twist a little deeper. So left arm is over or around your right knee. And if it's available and okay for your neck, you can look over your right shoulder. One more inhale here. Exhale, come back to center. Notice where your mind went as I showed up for a second. Inhale, bring your shins forward, come into half boat pose here. You can keep your fingertips on the floor behind you, or you can lift your arms forward. Three deep breaths here. Stay with your breath, one more. Exhale, pull the knees into your chest. And then we'll switch sides. So right leg goes to the bottom. Left leg steps across. Or your left leg is straightened, or your bottom leg is straightened out. Sit up tall. Left hand goes behind you, close to your spine. Right arm wraps around the knee, or goes past the knee, whatever is available to you. And then look over your left shoulder if that's okay for your neck. As you notice, I only have my fingers down, not my full hand. That's because my arms are short compared to the length of my torso. So you figure out what geometry is yours, whether you need your fingertips or your full hand. For most people, it's the full hand, so you can sit up straight. So you can press into the floor and sit up really tall. Two more breaths here. Make sure that your big toe mound of the left foot is rooted into the ground. Exhale, come back to center. Inhale, come back, lift your legs up again, half boat. Three here. Reach your heart forward, pull your navel back towards your spine. One more inhale here. Exhale, knees into chest. And then straighten out those legs. Reach your arms up with an inhale. Exhale, walk your hands forward as far as they go on your legs. Whether they reach your toes or whether they stay on your ankles or your shins, all is good. And when you've reached forward as far as you can, then just relax your neck and hang out here. Legs remain active, so pull your toes back towards your face. Keep your legs engaged, so that you can lift out of your sitting bones while reaching your heart forward. Two more breaths here. With your next inhale, slowly roll back up. And then with your exhale, scoot your booty forward and come to lay on your back. And then we're gonna lift our hips up into bridge pose. And you can grab your mat with your hands to bring your shoulders closer together, or if available, you can interlace your fingers underneath you to do the same thing, and walk those shoulders closer. With every inhale, press those hips a little higher. Last inhale here.
Exhale, slowly lower. And with that, we're going to come into your final resting pose. Lay one hand on your belly, one hand on your heart. Take a deep inhale into the belly, into the chest. Hold it on top for a moment. Exhale. Stay empty for a moment. Inhale, belly. Inhale, chest. Hold on top. Exhale. Inhale, belly. Inhale, chest. Hold at the top. Exhale. And then bring your arms to your side. And stay here for as long as you like. This final resting pose is important for the integration of your practice.
Thank you so much for letting me guide you through your practice. Stay here for as long as you wish.